Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this video, we're going to do a very super simple Dolly zoom in HitFilm Express. So you're starting to see this effect becoming more and more popular as it is easier to do this effect simply and quickly in almost any kind of editing software. So the first thing is you want to determine, does this video footage have the camera moving away from it, or does this video footage have the camera moving towards it? Okay, because it'll change. You do want footage where either the camera's moving in a little bit or the camera's moving out a little bit. You don't want to get carried away and go too far because then you will lose a lot of resolutions. So we're going to start with the example of the footage moving away, or the camera, I mean, moving away. I'm going to just drag this into my editor timeline. I'm going to use the slider to readjust the scale a little bit. All right. And now what I need to do is I need to compare the very last frame of this footage with the very first frame of this footage. So if I hit my page down key, I can go to the very end. If I then hit the comma key, I can back up one. And I'm just going to temporarily put in this footage on the video track above it so that I can see it. And if I open up the controls panel of that, I can go ahead and change the opacity to 50%. So now I sort of have an idea of, you know, what the difference is between that one and that one, right? If I back up, I can highlight the raw footage itself that I'm going to be changing, and opening up the transform properties, I can adjust both the position and the scale, or keyframe both the position and the scale. If I hit my page down, so now there I am, I can go ahead and make some adjustments to the position and the scale until I think I'm pretty close.
A few moments later.
So now that I've done that, I can go ahead and delete that. Okay. And now when you watch this footage, you can see that there's sort of a parallaxing effect happening there with the car essentially staying still, but the background changing, right? Okay. Let's do the other one. This time I have some raw footage of my camera moving towards this tiki torch, and this is a bigger movement for sure. Since it is moving towards this, I want to match the front end of this. So this time I'm going to drag this and basically put it on in front. I'm going to skip forward one frame so that I can zoom in here a little bit more and just slide that. So now when I back up, I have the last frame matching to the first, and I can go ahead and change the opacity of this. Now that I have that, I can go ahead and skip to the end here by hitting my page down key, opening up the transform properties. I can keyframe the scale and position. And now if I page up and then comma over, I have the difference here. And if I go ahead and adjust that,
a few moments later.
So then when I have that dialed in, I can go ahead and delete the original footage. And now you can see that the keyframing of that. So as a result, what we have is I have two different clips here now that I've done. One where the dolly zoom goes away and one where the dolly zoom comes in. And basically that's it. You can do it right on the editor timeline. Very simple. Keep framing it there. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Otherwise, thanks for watching.